was the back and forth between Marcus May and, of course, Jamal Adams. And I don't know what the hell Marcus May is doing. I don't know why he decided to inject himself into this whole thing. And then reading the mentions after Marcus May's comment to Jamal Adams about having, you know, all this false love come his way now is monumental idiocy to me, because these two guys are beloved by Jet fans, and they are treating Jet fans like trash. And I have no idea why they feel like they need to put their opinions out on social media, because they look like dopes right now.
Yeah, I mean, Marcus May, I didn't have as big of a problem with what Marcus May said as Jamal Adams' quote tweet, where he basically said, the thing I'm going to miss most is balling next to you. Like, all right, we're already out the door. I mean, you can't trade yourself, Jamal. I'm sorry. I know you're trying your best, and you're becoming the biggest distraction in the world, so it becomes too big of a problem for the Jets. I know the playbook. We've seen it a million times in the NBA. NFL players are starting to do it now, you know, with Antonio Brown's craziness, Jalen Ramsey. Craziness. You're trying to do the same thing, but you know, you can't just make the assumption that you're gone, and you put stuff out there like that on a consistent basis. I mean, if you ever do come back to the Jets, it's going to be some fences that have to be mended. To me, it's as ridiculous as
situation. That's the point. You're not going to win with guys like this. You're just not going to win with guys. I'm sorry.
He's a great player, though, man.
I'm not saying he's not a great player. Odell Beckham Jr. is a great player. Individually, yeah, they're fantastic players. But
to me, those two are different.
You want to know something? Every fan of the New York Jets will tell you that he's a terrific player. They love the guy. They want the guy to stay here. They don't want the guy to go anywhere else. What game he is playing is, I don't know how else to describe it other than idiotic. What he is doing, and the way that he is distancing himself from the franchise. And I mean, just like, if you're a Jet fan, if you are a passionate, and I believe me, I have a lot of family friends, and even my daughter's a huge Jet fan. I mean, I'd be pissed at both of these guys.
Oh, yeah.
And Marcus May to say, well, I'm getting all this false love now because, you know, now all of a sudden they love me because you're leaving and all this other crap.
Like, well, I believe him.
No. Time out. But, like, you know, Marcus has been hurt since he's got here until last year, and he played well last year under Greg Williams.
Right.
And you finally saw what Marcus May was somewhat capable of. And I think a lot of Jet fans were feeling really good about that. And then all of a sudden, out of the blue, he decides to get on the social media sewer pit and put out his points of view about how he's receiving all this false
love. That didn't bother me at all. That's what he got, because a bunch of people saw that Jamal Adams was leaving, and these fans were like, hey, we love you, Marcus, we love you. You would never leave us. Oh, we love you. And he just decided to comment on it. That's, I mean, compared to what Jamal Adams is doing, that Marcus May thing is a blip on the radar
screen. What I'm saying is he got himself involved when he didn't need to. That's the point.
Well,
you know, and I don't know what the hell's going on. These players are trying to make the Jets look bad. That's the point. I mean, that's what they're doing. And I don't know. I mean, I've been over the Jets now since they moved to New Jersey, I don't know, 25, 30, 40 times, whatever. And I look at that building, I look at that setup, and I'm like, damn, this would be like the greatest place in the world to play.